So yeah, we're on the channel again. The first card we got for you is Nine of Swords. So I believe you guys are thinking a lot, thinking heavily. You are thinking of getting someone's attention or getting to another destination. Okay, some of you are worried about someone or someone wanting to reach out to you. Some of you want them to reach out to you, and some of you do not want them to reach out to you. We have Six of Wands. Some of you want more, some of you want to achieve more in your career field, okay? You want to be respected, and you want things to move forward in your career as well. Some of you are not getting a promotion, and you're very, very upset about it. You feel you are worth, and you are being put down, okay? So yeah, that's the overall I see for you. So let's start about your partner. So how does your partner see you? Again, if you got Nine of Swords for your partner, we got King of Wands for them. So this person definitely has lots of passion for you, but it's still holding back, holding the, I don't know, I won't say F words today, but I feel some of them are still holding back. They are not wanting to open up about their feelings, okay? But with King of Wands, they definitely want to. They will take action, but as of now, as of today, I believe they are not, okay? So that's the overall. With the Moon card, they are hiding their feelings. For some of you, this person might be in another relationship. They are not wanting to open up is because they haven't ended something that they should in order to be with you. Okay? There's something shady going on. For some of you, they are coming in with a Page of Cups. That's an offer. So I feel you should be hearing from this person if you haven't yet in the coming days. So I believe I've told you guys that up till 6th of June, things are going to be a little tough, a little hard for you. From the 7th and 8th onwards, things are going to get a little easier and a little, you are going to feel a little less heavy. I believe today was the day many of you guys were feeling very heavy, very exhausted, very drained, wanting to just let go of everything and just, fix yourself. But I feel right now, you do not have to think so much. Everything will get, fixed, and whatever needs to end should be ended in order for you to reach to this point, okay? So you know, if you know that you are in a very toxic relationship or you are in connection with someone who is very much manipulative and fake and is only with you for sexual benefits or financial benefits, then darling, you know you don't have to watch tarot for that. You know, and you should be ending that in order to move towards something more healthy and something more giving, okay? So that's the overall energy. So let's start. How does your partner see you? This is a person who you love, who you have in your mind, in your heart, and who you secretly want to be with, okay? So this person might be a Scorpio. This person might be Aries, Virgo, Taurus. For some of you, it's a fire sign, Sagittarius, Leo. For some of you, it's a water sign, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. I see a lot of water, fire, Taurus, and Virgo, okay? So with Hierophant, again, Taurus card. But you are juggling. You are not sure if you should be making a move towards them. And the best thing as of now you feel is to stay single from them. Or you are single from them, okay? So let's take a card for your partner. Holy Angel Spirit Guide, please help connect with the energy of Libra's partner. What is going on in their mind, heart, and soul? What do they really want from Libra? What are their intentions, feelings, and what action are they willing to take towards the sign of Libra? So let's take one card. How do they see you? Okay. How does this person see Libra? Sorry. They see you as someone who is in control of their life. Sometimes this person sees you as someone who's very dominating and controlling, and someone who doesn't like to be played with. Okay, so they know that you are not someone they should play with. If they can only be back with you if they want something serious, and you are not looking for some fun time. Okay, so they know that you are some serious person that doesn't like to be taken for granted or played with. Okay, so they see you as someone who's very controlling, who has their life figured out, who knows what they are doing, and who's someone who is well-to-do. Okay, so let's see how they feel for you. How does this Libra soulmate feel for Libra? What are their real feelings? What do they really feel for Libra in their heart, not in the mind, the heart? One card that represents how this Libra soulmate see Libra. They are really real feelings towards the sign of Libra. some of you got 10 of wands, so they feel burdened. They know that you are the one, but they also know that they have to do a lot of work. Okay. For some of you, they know that you have walked away from them with six of swords, but they also know that you are stalking them. Okay, so they know that you are stalking them. With five of pentacles, this person is feeling left out in the cold by you. They know that you are giving them the cold shoulder. Okay, so for feelings, we have 10 of cups and page of wands. So they want to start something with you, okay, but they are holding back. Okay, they know that they broke your heart, and they know that they should make the changes in order to be back with you. They are the ones that are responsible to bring in peace into this connection. So when it comes to feelings, they feel like you are the one for them that makes them happy emotionally, and they should make a move towards you. Okay, so when it comes to feelings, they do have strong feelings for you, but they know that they did you wrong, and they do not know how to come towards you, because they know that they were the ones that broke your heart. They were the ones that made you doubt everything. Okay, so with nine of pentacles, they know that you are single as well, but they are still doubting it. They have having their doubts, but some of them know that you are single. Okay, with seven of pentacles, they are waiting for an opportunity to return back to you. With ace of pentacles, I very much see this person wanting to start fresh with you and wanting to take that leap of faith and forward movement towards you. Okay, so these are the two cards I'm getting for action. I also see eight of wands, so I see messages coming for many of you. But right now you have blocked this person, or you are energetically blocking this person. With three of pentacles, your sole purpose is your work, your finances, and not your romantic life. With ten of wands, when it comes to the love life, you are burdened. You feel like this is way too much work to get back with this person, and this person also feels the same way. But this person is wanting to work, is wanting to message, is wanting to come forward. Okay, with the sun card, I believe you know that this person is your happiness, and this person also feels the same way, that growth, expansion, happiness, prosperity, and all that they ever want in their life, they can only have it with you. But the problem is, darling, you both are juggling. You both have certain obsessions, addictions that you should let go of. You think about each other every day, but when it comes to feelings, you guys just behave ice cold. Okay, with the tower card, there has been a breakup or break. You know, you guys have been on a break from each other. You guys are not expressing. You guys are feeling heartbroken, and you guys are very much ignoring each other, and you guys are very, very focused on your finances, you both. Okay, so let's see what action this person is willing to take towards you. What action is a Libra soulmate wanting to take towards Libra? One card that represents this person's action towards the sign of Libra. So right now they are away from you, but I believe with Ace of Pentacles, this person is going to make a move towards you. Okay, with Three of Cups, this person very much wants a union with you. But with Five of Swords, they have their doubts. They have their own doubts. Okay, Five of Swords to me is doubts, having negative thoughts like this might never work and stuff like that. But with Nine of Cups, you are their happiness, you are their wish fulfillment. Okay, but with Ten of Swords, they also know that they are the ones that got to this point. They know that they literally ended this. Okay, with Ten of Swords, they know that they'll have to start again with you. They know that they are the ones that ended everything with you. Okay, with Three of Wands, they were the ones that moved on from you. Okay, but I do feel with King of Swords, they will open up now. They will open up. Okay, so what's the outcome going to be like? Where do we see this leading? Where do we see this leading? I believe with Five of Swords, you guys might have really had some bad fights with each other, a lot of mind games and stuff like that. So what's the one card that represents where this is leading to, or what's the outcome going to be like for Libra and their soulmate? The person Libra is thinking of or having in their mind, where is this leading to? We have Ace of Cups and Ace of Wands, two aces here. So this was very much a one-time reading. So I believe with Ace of Wands and Ace of Cups, I believe there is going to be a new beginning. And it is coming. Okay, this is for the month of June. But darling, you both also know that there is a lot of work to do. You both know that this is almost at a point where you have to start again. Things are not going to start from where it ended. You will have to literally start again with each other. You know, there is a lot of work to be done. You both are waiting for each other to approach, but I believe this person will take action towards you. I see this really moving forward from let's say 8th to 10th, this person might communicate, might make things forward, might move things forward. And I believe for many of you, you will definitely hear from this person. But if you know that this person is toxic, is fake, is just a player, then do not try to connect with this reading or do not try to fit in. Okay, when you know that this person is clearly a player and is just coming back to have sex with you or to just have some financial benefits from you, then don't even try to take this person back. You know that moving on is the best option. Okay, so let's take two advice cards for Libra. What does Libra need to know about their soulmate and about the soulmate relationship? Pay attention to red flags. The signs are cautioning you. Okay. Second card we got for you is engagement. Your love life is ascending to a higher level of commitment. Where it means engagement, you are going to have a love life. You guys have never had a love life for the past few months. So when it means engagement, it doesn't mean a practical engagement. It means that your love life is going to move forward. Okay. So yeah. But I feel for many of you with Six of Swords and Judgment, many of you have made a decision of walking away. Though you might still have feelings for them or might still have them in your mind, but many of you have made a decision of walking away and starting something fresh somewhere else. Okay, so that's the overall I see. This reading might not resonate with each and every one of you, but if you have been my subscriber for the past few months, then this should connect with you. Okay, so if it does connect with you, hit the like button, let me know in the comment section, subscribe to this channel, and if you want a personal reading with me, reach me out on my email. I only take PayPal payments, and it's going to be 5 days waiting. Thank you so much.